बिस्मिल्लाह रहमान रहीम, अस्सलाम वालेकुम। इन द प्रीवियस क्लास वी डिस्कस अबाउट व्हाट इज ओएलएम, ऑनलाइन एनालिटिकल माइनिंग। और व्हाट इज ओएलएम? ओएलएम इज अ इंटीग्रेशन ऑफ द ओएलएपी विद द डेटा माइनिंग टेक्निक्स। दैट इज व्हेन वी अप्लाई द डेटा माइनिंग टेक्निक ऑन द ओएलएपी, दैट इज व्हिच इज अ टूल फॉर द डेटा वेयरहाउस, देन इट इज रिप्रेजेंट बाय डेटा OLAM. We have discussed this one. Today we will discuss about the what is the OLAM architecture. What is the architecture and how the OLAM integrate or correlate with the OLAP. That is how do they work OLAM with the OLAP. That is applying the mining theory. So we can apply the mining theory, mining technique on the OLAP, then how do we get this? This is today we will discuss about the framework. As represented, it is integrated OLAM and the OLAP architecture. OLAM and the OLAP architecture. It started with the here in this OLAM architecture can be represented by the four layer. Layer 1, 2, 3 and 4. Layer 1 represented by data repository. Name that is term is a data repository. Secondly, layer number 2 is represented by MD, multi-dimensional database. Layer 3 is represented by the OLAP and OLAM integration, how they link together, correlate together. Layer number 4, user interface, how the user interacted with the system with this architecture. Then obviously it means you have different layer. In order to communicate or correlate these different layers, layer 1 to layer 2, layer 2 to layer 3, layer 3 to layer 4, some API will be required. Application program interface will be required. So this API, database API, is used to link or use for the access data from the layer 1 to layer 2. What about the second? This is the API, data cube API. It is used for the access from the layer 2 layer 3. And third one is about the graphical user interface API. Now let's start with the basic one. This is layer 1. What are the different features for the layer 1? Recall what is the basic concept for the data warehouse. The basic concept for the data warehouse is it is a centralized database repository maintained at the center. Moreover, it has four features. It retrieves the data from the entire organization. So in other words, we can say these are the databases, different databases for the entire organization. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Different 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 number of branches, whatever. So these are the databases were there, maintain the transaction database. What we need to do, we need to apply the tools. As we saw in the previous slide, we talk about the five different tools. Here we apply the data integration. In the back end, we apply, means obviously in the organization, retrieve the data from the entire organization. These data may have some duplication, some error, some incomplete data, some garbage were there. All of these garbages or impurities or some transformation will be required, different format representation or some duplication, etc. They will be removed. So as we saw, applying these tools with the transaction database, then it will send toward the this information will be sent toward the data warehouse. As you can see, this is data warehouse. Then after the data warehouse, this is the data in the form of relational database. Well, it means applying some filtering, we will convert these database into the multi-dimensional database or in the data cube. Here, until now, here we are in the form of relational database. But here, in the second layer, we will convert this data into multi-dimensional cubes. Recall that we in the multi-dimensional cube we talk about the full materialization. For example, we talk full materialization that is more than a large number of dimensions can be easily computed here. So as it is shown here, it's a multi-dimensional database. Then we also have the metadata. Here we also have the metadata. What is the property of the metadata? Metadata, it's a data. It defines the data warehouse objects. Here, in the metadata, it defines the data warehouse objects or the detailed data warehouse structure. Then what we have done here? Here, for example, you can see we have the MDDB multi-dimensional database. We have the OLAP server, etc. Moreover, recall that we have in the previous slide we talk about the five different type of tools: accession number one, accession number two, cleaning number three, data transformation number four, load, and number five, refresh. This will be applied here. Then, as I mentioned about the here, metadata can also be described as a data directory. A data data warehouse object, detail of the what is the structure of the here, what is the data history, or what is the algorithm will be used for the summarization, mapping, etc. Then let's talk about the third here. Let's talk about the third layer. Then in the third layer. Yes, here the client in the third layer, here the client contain the query of reporting and the tool. Let's talk more about what are these concepts were there. Here we can in the third tier we can apply, for example, the characterization, the association, the correlation, or the classification, prediction, or the cluster analysis we can perform. Here is how, let me show you here. How these interacted with the system. Moreover, in the OLAP engine, for example, we can apply the OBDC object database connectivity, etc. Then here in the query constraints based mining queries, some constraints, some limitation, some restriction will be there. Then it contains a constraint based mining query. We are required, it means this query will be generated, will be sent to the from the graphical user interface to the layer 3. Then between OLAP and OLM searching, then what we get here, what will be the output? Mining results means that here we have the knowledge discovery of the hidden pattern. Some knowledge we have discovered, some pattern we can find, something that was previously hidden we can find out. Then we can retrieve the result here as so this is the architecture. We consist of the OLMA architecture, or how the integrate of OLM with the OLAP architecture in this slide. Yes, now let's this is the end of the chapter number 2. Today inshallah we will discuss about the chapter number 3. We have completed chapter number 2. Today we will discuss about the decision analysis. What is the decision analysis? Why do we require this decision analysis? What are the features for decision analysis? Let me discuss one. What are these concepts? First we talk about what the decision analysis. Okay, what are the feature advantages or something will be there? Decision analysis provide a framework to make important decision. What is a framework? Framework means something systematic approach, some systematic versus step by step process. What is the architecture? What is the architecture so that we can make important decision? This is represented by the framework. So decision analysis provides us the framework of systematic approach so that we can make the decision. What is the advantage? If we apply the systematic approach, then even our decision at the end will be wrong, but we have the justification that this is for this scenario, for this problem I applied this scientific approach, and for any reason the result may be wrong, output may not be very good, but I apply the standard solution. So then it somehow have the face saving. Then decision analysis, it allows us to select a decision from a set of possible decision alternatives and uncertainties regarding the future exists. Recall, take simple scenario in which, suppose I Mohammed Shaib, I have 1 million riyal. What I want to invest this 1 million riyal to, so that I want to get maximum profit. I want to get the profit. No, I also want the maximum or optimal profit. Nobody want make the investment just to get the profit. You always willing to have some optimal or the maximum profit. Then I have number of choices were there, number of alternatives were there. Alternative number one, for example, I can invest in the foreign exchange, purchase the foreign exchange. I can maybe purchase some gold prices. As you can see, the gold price has been rise since last couple of years. For example, in 2015, the gold price around 142 riyal per gram for the 22 karat. Right now, it is more than 192 riyal. Third choice can be purchase the share price for the IPO, Aramco IPO. I will purchase the IPO or share for the Aramco because it is growing. Moreover, might be possible because right now the price of the real estate is increasing day by day. I can purchase some of the real estate property over there. So it means I have number of possible alternatives over there. Decision alternative number one, number two, number three, number four. Obviously, each of the alternative we have some uncertainties over there. Uncertainties means something you cannot control. Something you control. We are the uncertainties. So over each of the decision, they have some uncertainties. Then decision analysis provide a mechanism. A decision analysis allow us that how can we select a decision from the possible set. I just give the example for five possible possibilities for the investment to get the maximum profit. Although all of these four or five example, my target is I want to get maximum profit. So it means decision provide a mechanism. That how can we make us select a decision. Then third feature is the body. Yes, the goal is to optimize the returning result in term of decision criteria. This is our goal that we want to optimize the result, optimize the return. What is the maximum profit? In the term of decision criteria, for each of these criteria, what might be the possible return? Moreover, do we have other benefit for the decision analysis? For example, yes, it provides a quantitative support, some quantitative support for the decision maker. Quantitative means some number. It gives us base solving, means applying some mathematics so that I can get number. This number shows what is the decision. For example, how can you decide which one is the good student, bad student, based on the grading? That based on the grading A plus A, and these are represent some grading. The same you can apply in the mathematics. We apply the decision analysis. These number give us which might be more profit or less profit. Then the decision analysis deal with evaluating complex alternative. Sometimes here I give the example for the simple one. Sometimes we have a very complex alternative over there. Then it provide the standard approach for the evaluating of the complex alternative in term of certainty or in term of what are the corresponding values. So a lot of advantages were there for the decision analysis. Now let's talk about the decision problem. Here in order to have the decision problem, as mentioned, first we need to understand what is the concept for the decision table and the decision tree, and what's the difference between them. Decision table and decision tree. What is the decision table? if we are making the decision against some data element were given to us, then we can use the decision table. On the other hand, for the tree, recall that in the tree, recall that what is the concept, general concept for the tree. A tree consists of number of branches. Each of the branches, we may each of the branches they represent something node, nodal leaf, etc. Then, in other words, we can say what's a decision tree? Decision is making the decision on the series of the data. They are different from one branch to another branch, from one branch to another branch. Then we use the decision tree. Now let's talk about what is. First, we will identify the decision problem. What exactly the problem do we have? This is exactly the problem. What are the scenario for which we require some decision? For example, the problem scenario, I have some money, I want to make profit, one of the scenario. Problem number two is, for example, that suppose for different scenarios, identify what is the problem for which your decision will be required. Then, in order to solve the problem, we may have the different alternatives to solve the problem for different alternatives. For example, giving assignment to you. For example, different students, they solve the problem, solve the assignment with different perspective, a different perspective. So it means they have different alternative, different the number of more number of options. I give the example. I want to have the maximum profit. I have different options where they invest in the IPO, investment to purchase the gold, investment to purchase the real estate property, investment for the purchase of the purchase of the we can say foreign exchange, etc. So these are the number of alternatives. That even event of nature, state of the nature. What is state of the nature? State of the nature. State of the nature. They represent, yes. These state of the nature, they represent a set of possible scenarios. So, or what are the possible scenario on which the decider does not have any control? Something. Each of the option you as a decider, I cannot have the control. I must keep in mind. These are the represent the state of the nature. Means something you do not have the control, but somehow it can affect your decision. Then finally, we have the outcome. These are the corresponding what we have the finally what we have the outcome. Now let's talk about the description of the decision table. Are as we saw in the previous slide, what the decision table and decision tree. First, we need to know about the what are different important terminologies. What is alternative? What is the state of the nature? Alternative means different choices. I give with the example of what our different alternative mean. Investment in the purchasing of real estate, investment to purchase in the gold, etc. These are different alternatives. Then, what are the state of the nature? Event are an occurrence over which the decider has no control. Here, the decider does not have any control. These are the state of the nature. For example, I give the example for the IPO. For the IPO, the purchasing of the share. Might be possible the government has made the restriction. For example, I want even for example the expect even might be possible I cannot purchase the some of the shares. I cannot purchase some means something that is beyond our control. But they somehow affect the decision. Then let's talk about what is the symbol use the decision tree. This symbol represented with the square along with the circle. This symbol for the square they represent the decision mode from which one of these several alternative may be selected. Means in the next slide we talk in term of in the next slide we will also discuss in term of the this node the concept for the decision tree is that when we saw this square it represent a decision node from which several alternatives may be selected. Then we have the this circle represents state of the nature. State of the nature, what is state of the nature? An occurrence over which the decider does not have any control. Let's see with the example. Here, this is a decision table. This is a decision table. For example, here, in order to make the decision, we have different alternative. Alternative number one, alternative number two. Or as just for your understanding, I have 1 million riyal. I have two options. Either I can purchase some of the real estate, or number two, for example, what about the I or either I can purchase the gold. Then this is alternate number one and two. What about the state of the nature? State of the nature means scenario in which I do not have control, one and two represented. Then what is interpretation of output? Output number one is, outcome number one is, for the first alternative, this is the corresponding state of the nature, corresponding something I do not have control. This will be the outcome. On the other hand, for the same alternative number one, for another scenario, this will be the outcome. In other words, we can say it is the matrix over alternative one and two towards the state of the nature one and two. And the, what are the corresponding output? Output number one, outcome number two, number three, and number four. Inshallah, this concept will be clear when we solve the numericals. Then this concept will be much more clear to us. Then, what about the decision tree? For example, here, the decision tree can be described as we saw, this represent the decision node. As we saw, this represent the decision node, and these represent the state of the nature. So here, from the decision node, we have two alternatives. Recall the previous slide, we talked about the definition of the decision node is from which several alternatives can be selected. So for decision node, I have two alternatives. For alternative number one, we have the state of the nature one, and two states were there. State one, state two. For the state one, outcome one. For state two, output two. Again, as we saw here, state one and state two, for the alternative one and two, the corresponding outcome one and two, one, two, three, four. This is the example. So for outcome number one, two, three, four, for the alternate one and two, and the other state one and two for the one, state one and two for the two. Let's talk about the product tree, decision tree, product decision tree. I will give the example also. Here, this is the decision node. Okay, no, a decision node has how many? 1, 2, 3 alternatives were there. Okay, then for the one and two, we found that this is the state. The state of the nature one and two. For the outcome, this in other words, we can say outcome one, outcome two, outcome three, outcome four, or outcome something five. Okay, doesn't matter. Outcome one. I will give example. Suppose here, for example, if they mention about the construct large plant, construct small plant, do nothing. I will give the practical example so that suppose as we found what the problem scenario is. In a couple of years, since the last couple of years, the kingdom changed the regulation about the driving. Right now, the female, they also be allowed for the driving. It means as an investor, there is a chance that there are more number of cars will be required. More number of cars will be required. So as an investment, suppose I think that the it is a for me, if more number of chance will be missed or moreover, as an investment, I think it is profitable to have a large construct large car plant. Why? Because I think the what are the favorable market do we have? Because do the people have the money? They can purchase the car. Yes, the people they have the money, they purchase the car. Moreover, they also have the arrangement. They can get the loan from the bank. Oh, this is the advantage. These are the advantage. It means something for the investor. Moreover, more number of cars will be required because the kingdom changed the regulation. It is something favorable. It means this is one of the state of the nature. One of the state of the nature is favorable in terms of I cannot have the control. I can change the government rule regulation. It is not something I can do. Something beyond my control. But this is something favorable to me. Outcome is favorable to me. Now let's talk about the Let's talk about what is unfavorable. Might be possible. The another scenario I want to discuss is unfavorable as. Unfavorable is because right now the people have the different choices were there. As you are commonly familiar, that some of the people, families, if they purchase, they fall in love with the brand. For example, GMC. They try because they are familiar about the GMC, American GMC, American or Chevrolet American. They are much more addict to the brand or to the we can say brand or to the market. So it is something unfavorable. Even if I want to make the construct the last run, how can I something we can say something? How can I convince the people that no purchase something? For example, my brand name is something new. Shape, for example, Shape car. How can I convince them? How can I convince them? Because one thing is here. Although there are more opportunities were there, but the people sometimes they were addicted with their brand. No, they think that for example, another we can say. The people who, for example, the families, they always try to purchase or edit for the SUVs or if they Toyota Corolla, Hyundai, etc. So the point is, I cannot convince them easily. Convince them that something a new model people they can purchase. So it is something unfavorable. Now let's talk about the on the other hand. Second option is I will not construct a full-fledged car plant, large plant. Just the assemble, just make the assembling. Assembling means I will purchase the parts and assemble here. Purchase the parts from I will contact with the different brands and I told that I will assemble them. Okay, and I want to construct a small plant, just the assembling. Then what are the favorable? What are the unfavorable? Favorable is some assembling means obviously the cost will be low because I am here for the government right now giving incentives. The government gives the incentive that if you will make the investment, something opportunity. Then what is the unfavorable? Here the unfavorable cases, even for the construct the small plant, I need to have some skillful and unskillful labor. Here the labor cost is high as compared to other countries. The labor cost is high. Moreover, the government also has the regulation that some naqat system will be there. So it means the government also set the minimum wages. These are the minimum wages for the Saudis and non Saudis, for the Saudis, etc. Then it means for the investor, I want to have this small plant. Then I must consider what might be must fulfill the requirement for the naqat system, must fulfill the something. It means it is beyond my control. I cannot control them. Something unfavorable because in the Southeast Asian countries, they have cheap labor. Have you ever wondered why the Apple company, Apple, Samsung, they construct their smartphone through China, Vietnam? Why? China, Vietnam, is because they are the very cheap labor. All of the smartphone they are assembled in China because they are cheap labor. So then the other third one is about the do nothing. No, I think that these are the scenario or the what are the atmosphere, and even if the atmosphere until right now it is not so amazing. So I will not do anything. In this slide, what we are trying to understand concept for the product. Decision tree, in which we try to understand the concept for the decision node and the state of the nature with example. Now let's talk about the decision model. What are the different decision model? What different type of models were there? Broadly be categorized as the type of the decision model are. For these are the type of the decision model: decision making with uncertainty. With no probability, with decision making with risk, decision making with perfect information, with the imperfect information, and decision making in light of competitive theory. Recall that in chapter number one, we discussed this concept. In chapter number one, we discussed the fundamental concept for different type of models. In chapter number one, I told that we will discuss in detail what are the detail of these different model one by one in this chapter number three. Let's talk about the decision making under certainty. The first model is, if you want to make a decision under certainty, you are very certain, means you know what is the state of the nature, what might be happen, or for the type of the decision, you know if some standard procedure, some standard protocol, standard procedure, they are available. So in other words, the decision, if you make a decision under certainty, you are very certain, you are very sure. How do you can be sure? You know the future state of the nature assumed to be known. You know what might be happen. Whatever the alternative do we have, you know what will be the outcome. You are very sure, pretty sure. It means you need to follow the standard protocol. People who previously applied the solution, you know what might be the outcome. So in other words, you can say for those problem scenario, you know what will be the outcome, or the future state of the nature is known. Let's talk about the second type. Decision making under uncertainty along with no probability. It means you don't know what might be happen. What might be happen? You want to make a decision, but even you are uncertain, also you do not have any probability. Probability means at least you know something, but here you are uncertain, or moreover you are uncertain what might be the happen. And moreover, you also do not have any probability involved. Then, what are the corresponding analysis model or feature as? Let me clear it. Here, there is no knowledge about the probability of the state of the nature. Here, you do not have, you are making the decision. Moreover, you do not know about the probability of the state of the nature that will be occur. So some other technique will be applied. The point is here we are discussing about the six different type of modeling. Each of the modeling, they have the corresponding techniques, subcategories were there for the technique. We will discuss these techniques one by one. Third one is about the decision making with risk. It means you want to make a decision, but also some risk were there. Some risk means some probabilities. Recall the what is the concept of the probabilities. If I will throw a dice, or throw a coin, I know what might be the outcome, either head or tail, or either face value 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 for the dice. But I cannot guarantee that for this first attempt, I got the head or tail. So this represents some probabilities. Here, example is, if I want to make a decision, but with some risk, some probability, then what are the corresponding features? You have some knowledge of the probability of the state of the nature. Some knowledge, you know, what are the 70% chance I will succeed, 70% for this type of business, or 30% chance that there is 30% chance. What does it mean by percent? Percent means these represent some probability of outcome, but you are not 100% sure. You are about the some probability of outcome. Fourth type of the decision is decision making with perfect information. In the decision making with perfect information, it means the future state of the nature is assumed known with certain probability. You know the future state of the nature. Future state of the nature is assumed known, but with some probability. The point is here, what does it mean by perfect information? Sometime what we are trying to do, sometime to get, so we get some additional information from some, for example, as I give the example for the investment, might be possible I will approach some consultant company for the investment, that I want to please make the guide or make a report of the feasibility report for the investment. Obviously they will ask me some money, they will ask, they charge some money, and they give the, they, because they have the deep in depth knowledge about the environment, they can give me the recommendation. So here, assume that whatever I get the information from that is something is have the importance worth consultancy, but if they also have some probabilities, perfect information. So the other decision making with assumed to be known and the probability. Then we have the decision making with imperfect information. imperfect information. Here, some of the scenarios are there in which at least we have how small information it has, but at least it can be counted. Even the small portion of quantity of the information have some worth. This we are presented as decision making with imperfect information, and Bayesian theorem will be applied for them. Bayesian theory will be applied. We will discuss in detail what is the Bayesian theory, how it will help them. Means might be possible we have right now, we have some probability of information. Moreover, I get some additional information which is not perfect along in the same with the probability. It means we have two different type of probabilities were there. Prior probability and the posterior probability. So they we will discuss later on. Then decision making in light of the competitive game theory. All the actors of the player are seeking to maximize the return. Let's see what are they. For example, about the what is the price of the Samsung toy, Apple and Huawei. What they are the competitor to each other. What they do? They set the prices. For recall that, for example, in the start of in the end of the previous year, Apple told that they will not for the next of the series they will not give you the charger. Although at the in the starting, the Samsung along with the Huawei, they also make us some they laugh something that they give something the bad comments, but at least what they do, Apple somehow compensate to reduce the charges. How it will compensate? That the charger will not be given to the next model. Later on, Samsung follow the same. So it what is the interpretation for this one? It means they are making the decision based on the what are the competitor they are doing. If the competitor they are doing, their competitor Apple, they make the decision, reduce the prices, reduce the with some of the accessories previously they were given, later on they will not be given, they will not be added. So it means they also required to be somehow make their decision. Or in simple we can describe as a game theory as playing a chess game with you. What I will do first, for example, first I have the move, I will make a move. Now it is your turn. In your turn you will check what the move I have made and what are the available slots for you. Then you will make your decision. Third is my turn again. So again this process will continue. Each of the player want to have the win the game or opt to win the game. So each of the player must keep on eye what their competitor they are doing. This is the basic concept. We will discuss what does it mean by the game theory. Now let's talk about the what are the different models. We have discussed six type of models. We will check one by one what are these models were there. Under uncertainty, decision making under uncertainty, we cannot compute the expected value and the decision based on the other criteria. It means for the decision making under uncertainty, we cannot use any probability or we cannot use expected value criteria. Because why? Because in the previous slide, I talk about the decision making with uncertainty means there is no knowledge about the probability of the state of the nature. This is the basic definition for the decision making under uncertainty. So some other criteria we will check in the next slide. What are these criteria? One method for making a decision under risk is to select that decision with the expected best experience. On the other hand, if we have some probability is there, then we can apply that decision making under risk criteria. Third one, but then the approach is normally referred to decision making under risk. So we will discuss these methods one by one. Let's see what are the different approaches in the category of the decision making under uncertainty. What are the different approaches were there? These approaches were, for example, here three type of approaches were there: Maximax, Maximin, and Equal Likely. Maximax, note that this concept two parts: Maximax, Maximin, and Equal Likely means equal like. Let's see. What are the property for the Maximax criterion? to the alternative that maximize the maximum return. Maximize the maximum. So here, for example, here, although in the next slide we will do the example. Just for the starting, we can say we will choose the which of the alternative which maximize the maximum output of every alternative. We will find out what is the maximum output. Then we will find out what is the maximum amount of them. About the maximum, choose the alternative that maximize the minimum output outcome. Mean for these cases, first we will come find out what is the minimum outcome. Then out of this minimum, what is the maximum? Equal likely means first we will compute the average. The highest output of the average will be selected. Now we will discuss one by one of these different type of uncertainties: maximax, maximin, and equal likely. Here we have three alternatives were there. As we in the start of the lecture, we discussed the example: construct large plan, construct small plan, and do nothing. And these are the state of the nature. These are the state of the nature will be given to us for the favorable market and unfavorable market. And these are some values number given to us for the outcome. Recall that we talk about the outcome 1, outcome 2, outcome 3, outcome 4. So they are the state of the nature. So how many alternatives do we have? Three alternatives. We have three alternatives. One, two, three. How many state of the nature? We have two state of the nature, that favorable, unfavorable. What we are required to do? We require to make a decision under uncertainty. What are different categories were there? Three categories were there: maximax, maximin, and equal likely. Now, for example, how do we compute this? How do we compute the maximax? First, in order to compute the maximax, first we will compute what is the maximum value for this row. What is the maximum value for this row? 200,000 minus 100,000. The maximum value is 200,000. What about the maximum value for this row? The maximum value for this row is 100,000. It means what are these? These are the maximum in a row. Then what about the third one? Do nothing, zero. Out of this maximum, what is the maximum? Out of this maximum, which from the row, which one? Which is the maximum value from this column? We found this value is the maximum, so this will be selected. In other words, this will be selected. Now I will select this one, change the color so that it will be. Now let's talk about the second one, about the minimum, about the second maximum. First we need to find which is the minimum value for the row. What is the minimum value in the row? This is the minimum value in the row, minus 180. Then what is the minimum value in the second row? That is a construct small plan, that is minus 20,000. They are the minimum row. Out of this minimum, what is the maximum? Out of this minimum, what is the maximum? Here we have the value something in negative for the minus 180,000. Again, we have that something value in the negative, minus 20,000. Third one is about do nothing is zero. Do nothing is zero. So which one is the maximum value? First two values, they are negative. Third one is the positive. So it means this is the maximum. About the third one, for we will compute the average. How do we compute the average? Let me change the color. For example, how do we compute the average? To compute the average, we need to find what is the average between this them. 20,000 and minus 180,000 is equal to, then it is equal to 20,000. So 200,000 minus 180,000 is equal to 20,000. 20,000 divided by 2 is equal to, then the average is equal to 10,000. Summation divided by 2. Make a summation of these divided by 2, 10,000. What about this one? Here, make a summation that is 100,000 minus 20,000 is equal to 80,000 divided by 2 is equal to 40,000. This is 40,000. Third one is zero. For example, do nothing right now. We are dealing with nothing. Then out of these row average, this is the row average, which one is the maximum value? We found the maximum value is 40,000. The maximum value. So it is the equal likely. So based on the different under the category of the uncertainty, decision making uncertainty, there are three options were there: maximax, maximin, and equal likely. And in this slide we discuss about the approach, different type of approaches. We will discuss that, for example, later on today we will not discuss. We will discuss in detail what decision making under uncertainty. We will discuss in detail about these type of categories. For example, they give the example as that, yeah, the state of the nature. Yes, we will discuss maximum, principle of decision. So we were decision making criteria for the uncertainty. What we will discuss later on. Right now, today, we just had the introduction about the decision analysis. Okay, we will stop right now. So thanks of you. Inshallah, we will continue. Now you may leave the session. Thank you very much.